Hello, this is Matt, and I'm back to talk about gold, silver, copper, maybe even Bitcoin. Don't hang up the phone yet, but we are the narrators. We are the storytellers. This silver YouTube community, we are the best storytellers in the business. But you know what's nice? Gold, silver, and copper sell themselves, right? Our job is just to put it out in front of people and let them see the value in these coins. Because gold, silver, and copper have been around forever. They've just been lying, waiting, willing, ready. They've been sitting in drawers. They haven't been made since 1964, right? These silver coins are just waiting for their moment. They're like 7-Eleven. They're always open, but not always doing business.
We're sort of like 7-Eleven. We're not always doing business, but we're always open.
That was nicely put.
Thank you.
Now in 2011, when silver hit 50, little old Bitcoin was started in 2009, had just started getting its legs. 2015 became more well known. It was like this little thing that came out of jail, came out of prison, was locked up, and was finally released onto the community. Now, is Bitcoin's mission to come out here and distract people from silver, gold, and copper?
Lions and tigers and bears.
Why, you're nothing but a great big coward.
You're right, I am a coward.
Was it meant to be the faster rescue boat? As in, the dollar's being diluted and inflated. Prices are going up. Get out of the dollar. Find gold, silver, copper. But now, there's also this speedboat called Bitcoin. If you're a little bit of a risk taker, take it for a spin.
There's a flip side to that coin. What if you do got me boxed in? Then I gotta put you down. Because no matter what, you will not get my way. We've been face to face, yeah. But I will not hesitate, not for a second.
Now the last 5 years has been a firefight, right? You have the old school barbarous relic or the new school crypto scam. It's been a firefight, which is the best? And both sides have just been battling each other.
This was a fucking bomb dropping on Beaver Cleaverville. For a few seconds, this place was Armageddon.
There was a firefight!
So in honor of that fight scene and that movie, I had to have the piece that's hidden beneath this envelope. And I'll let you think about what that piece could be. And the major hint is Silversmith's Shield, Silver Soldier of Fortune, and that there's three of them that exist. 2.9 ounces, and the man Heads or Tails Living did a video about it recently where he was talking about he had that piece and was willing to let it go. So I saw his video, reached out, we agreed on a price, and I'm so excited to show you what's underneath that envelope. So this unboxing, again, from him says, "Hey Bub, thank you for the purchase. So glad to know this is going to a great home. Thank you for helping me in progressing what I'm doing with all the digital stuff." So I know he's raising money so that he can do better video production. And that's exciting, right? We're all stepping up our game because YouTube's fun, right? But it's hard. So you have to have the right tools. So I flip it over. He says, "Keep up the great content. Love your vids. Happy early anniversary." It's a secret. "Hope this finds you and everyone well. Have a good day. All right. Heads or tails living. So, yeah. So, I am going to use this piece in its secret to give to my wife because she loves that movie. It was from 1999. And the big reveal was the Boondock Saints. So, how cool is this round? I'm sorry. Not a round. This is just a piece of art. Beautiful. 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 So this says Bassam Metals, right? I may have said Silversmith Shield. Maybe I was incorrect. But Bassam Metals, beautiful work. I love the pistols. I love the cross. There was a firefight. Now, I know it was Silver Husky was the one, I believe, that really loved using that line. He has one. Again, we think Silver Soldier of Fortune has one. And now I have the third. So I am extremely excited to have this. It is a beautiful, beautiful piece. So thank you again. Heads or Tails Living, you rock, man. You have a great sticker. I hope that you're now able to get some more digital equipment, get your stuff going. It's great. This is a great community. I'm so, so thankful. And I'll show you the serial number again was 003. Bassam Metals. How cool. All right, back to the show.
For thee, my Lord, power hath descended forth from thy hand.
That our feet may swiftly carry out thy command, we will flow a river forth unto thee, and teeming with souls shall it ever be. In only part we fill thee, Spirit of Sanct.
And it doesn't matter whether you're collecting coins from our past or collecting digital crypto coins for the future. Both of them are on the same path, and I think they both can climb together. But it is a battle. We have to battle, guys.
Out of order. I show you out of order. You don't know what out of order is, Mr. Trask. I'd show you, but I'm too old. I'm too tired. I'm too fucking blind. If I were the man I was 5 years ago, I'd take a flamethrower to this place. Out of order. Who the hell do you think you're talking to?
The mission is actually the same, right? We're trying to offer people a way out of the dollar to go preserve their wealth, right? Get out of the dollar and into something that's actually moving forward that can be part of the future.
You hurt this boy, you're gonna be bad bums. The lot of you. And Harry, Jimmy, Trent, wherever you are out there, fuck you too!
Stand down, Mr. Slade.
I'm not finished.
And with gold, silver, copper, and Bitcoin, we don't need a celebrity. We don't need Elon Musk. We don't need a baseball player, a football player. We are the celebrities, guys. Us YouTubers that are putting out great content, we promote this hobby. We promote these coins.
This field, this game, is a part of our past, Ray. It reminds us of all that once was good and it could be again. Oh, people will come, Ray. People will most definitely come.
We are telling their story and we're going to make them survive. As somebody that loves coins, you're meant to go absorb as much content as you can and then reframe it and teach people what you know. That's your job, and it's an amazing job. Again, gold, silver, copper, they sell themselves, but you still have to have somebody up there telling their story, trying to twist it a little bit so that, you know, maybe it lands on somebody's conscience that says, this is a good idea, right? And it doesn't matter to me if it's coins or digital coins, right? We can join forces. If we battle each other, we'll probably lose. But consider this, what if, you know, all the Bitcoin boys and the crypto people, what if they start buying a little bit of silver too? Right? What can happen with that? You have people that are like-minded but believe in digital. What if they bought just a little bit of physical, guys, right? We have the same mindset. We both want the same things, but we're going about it a little bit different. So my thought is, even if you don't agree with it, teach them, right? Not in a negative way. We got to teach these guys how to go buy physical silver and gold and copper. Now, when the dollar falls apart, it's not going to be rainbows. It's not going to be unicorns and rainbows, guys. It's going to be tough. It's going to be hard, right? Everybody's mind is going to be, whoa, what's happening, right? Why is my dollar worth less? It's worth less and then worth less. Why does it cost me $12 to get a carton of eggs? Why is it a dollar an egg, right? These are things you're going to start dealing with. And we're not going to be safe, right? We're going to suffer too. But if we have coins, we're going to be a little better off. All right, so now you are ready. You have all the knowledge in your head. Go out there and make a video. Go talk to your friends. Talk to anybody you know. Tell them to go buy a little bit of gold, a little bit of silver. Thank you for being here, and I'll see you guys next time.
I'm doing it.
It is.
Believe that just fucking happened.
Is it dead?
Oh my God.
No more internal power struggle. We come together to overcome the little trouble.
I don't come to bow, you know. I come to conquer. I don't come to bow, I come to conquer.